So this morning, I introduced this video, and I just was talking about just the situation we're in with COVID-19 or coronavirus, and I just said, take care of your family, make phone calls, check up on people.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Because we're just in a position where people are getting sick, and it's just becoming more and more real, and it's more real than we had realized.
Right.
And I did mention that we have a family member who was in the hospital that could potentially have it.
Right.
It's not just that you get through it, it's that you take something from it. When the priest stopped, God said, stop right in the middle. Stop right now and say, this is the day the Lord has made. We can't take things for granted anymore, y'all.
So based upon what we're going through right now, what is something that we can get or gain and then bring it with us? What are something that you would bring with us that you learned from this?
Yeah.
Taking walks.
I just think that at least one good thing
being
is
patient.
Yeah.
Communication.
That like one good thing that's come out of this is people seem to be checking in more with like their neighbors and people, and that's a good thing. I just think not taking so much for granted, like we take for granted so much as far as like always having what we need from the grocery store and being able to go whenever we need to. And
us having been to these places that do lack, mm-hmm. and now we're in a position where it's like, we really have it good here. And so many people are like, what is happening? They're going in panic mode. And I was listening to this military guy on YouTube, and he was just talking about so many people are in a position of just fear right now, and we just make some crazy decisions. Like the reason why toilet paper and certain types of food are just flying off the shelf is because people are just scared. They don't know what's going to happen. And so
right.
We just need to be in the mentality of we versus me. Like, wait a second, look at this.
My turn.
But this guy from the military, he was just talking about, you know, when 9/11 happened, we went from a me country to a we country in the matter of, you know, overnight. When that happened, so many people just unified.
And I think a lot of people are. Like, I hear consistent stories of, like, people offering their groceries to other people at the store if they know that they're more in need. Or I mean, even this week I've had so many people reach out and just offer if we need anything to help, which is awesome. I just think more people stepping into that in the next couple weeks will really be what turns this around for our country. It'll be a good thing.
I was on Instagram Live and I was jokingly just talking about toilet paper and how we were only down to two rolls, which that was not a joke. We were literally down to two rolls. And there was a lady, very sweet, and she's like, got you covered. That night, her daughter, she had sent her daughter down the street, which she lives in our neighborhood,
mm-hmm.
with a whole pack
mm-hmm.
of toilet paper.
Mm-hmm.
So it was just very cool.
Mm-hmm.
It's just, you know, it's us just taking care of one another, but
mm-hmm.
it's interesting. Everything about this is weird. Everything
it's
about
so strange.
It is so weird. We're never going to forget it. Just pray and hope that we learn something from it and, you know.
Right, and I think just
things will be normal. You know, it's just gonna, it may take time.
It will. Oh, I think too, just making it, like with the we versus me, like we all are in, we're all, the whole world is in this situation. Like we're all in yucky spots. So instead of like lingering on how it's affecting you and how it just stinks for you, just, you know, remembering that everyone, like seniors aren't getting graduations, and some girls who've been planning their weddings for a whole year are not getting the wedding of their dreams now. And women are having to have babies without their spouse in the hospital with them.
This is like an introvert's like paradise though. Like,
oh
yes.
Yeah. Introverts still have like, their one or two people they need.
Like for me, I'm probably a mix of both.
Yeah, it depends on your mood.
I feel like the older that I'm getting, I'm becoming more introverted, but I'm like, I'm getting to the place where I'm like, I kind of want to hang out with people again, you know?
Mm-hmm.
It just gets difficult. Even going to like the store, you know, and then if you just cough or clear your throat, they look at you like you're, you know, you're just diseased. And sorry, I'm watching my daughter just
show love regardless and compassion. Yeah.
She's pulling this wedgie out of her butt. And
while our youngest
very distracting.
While our youngest tries to pull our 88-year-old grandfather into a pond. So
yeah,
things are going well.
You don't know what's true right now. Like, it's so hard. You turn on the news and it just creates a lot of anxiety, or social media. You know, Tricia the other night just had to cut it off and just be like, nope, I'm going to take a few days off, because we don't know what's true. Like, one side, it's like, man, things are getting better. The other side is like, it's becoming worse. And I mean, but God knows, and He's in control of it. He doesn't.
Yeah, He wasn't surprised by this.
Nope. So all we can do is just lean on Him. And
right. And it's encouraging. It's like superiorly. Is that a word? Superiorly?
Sure,
I don't know.
Be.
It's superbly weird to think about, but to know that, like, He's already in tomorrow.
So this is nothing new for God. It's nothing new. It's new to you. It's not new to God. God saw it coming. God is already in your tomorrow. And God says, give me my job back. God's job is tomorrow. Your job is today. Give us this day our daily bread. What I'm going to do today, I'm going to keep from killing my kids. That's what I'm going to do today. All right, good. That's your job.
And He's already in 2 weeks from now and 4 months from now. And when we're hopeful that things are normal again, He's already in that time too.
It's hard not to not fear or worry, but we just can't, because
it's a natural response.
It's right. And life is good. We just got to be smart right now. Be patient.
Stay home.
Stay home. Stay home.
Right.
Wash your hands.
Unless you need to go out, stay home.
Yeah.
Like, you don't need to go out for silly things.
Yep. We're praying. Praying hard.
I'm going to go see a big fish.
Hey! Get your toes off the counter! That's nasty!
Why? Oh gosh,
how are
those? Those are my favorite!
Okay, keep folding!
So, I'm guessing these are cookies. What? Dude, these look really good.
They're brownies!
Muscles for this part.
Oh, when you do that, one fell off and then I ate
them. Shocker.
I can see it all over your mouth. You guys don't even know how much of a cookie connoisseur I really am.
It's true.
That is true.
I could eat an entire 24 pack of cookies.
And not get sick.
With no problem.
You gotta start divvying them out. Let me get the pan.
That's a good word. Okay, tell me that don't look good. Woo!
All right, look. So we get like a little spoon like that. Okay.
I kind of want to doodle him. I think I'm going to doodle him.
Yeah. I don't need nothing more than you. I got everything. I've got you. We went walking through the hills, trying to pretend that we both know. Maybe if we save her, we could build a little home. But then the hailstorm came.
Daddy, your cookies are done.
Okay, hold on 1 second.
Marker.
One, two, three, four. There he is. Haley, you want to spin him around? Oh yeah. Oh yeah. You don't know me. Yeah. Okay. Okay. Party no. Oh! You dropped him. You dropped my heart. My party gnome. Right here. Make you banana bag. There he is. Now I just need a name for him. What's his name?
Bonds.
Bonds. There you go, guys. His name is Bonds. Bonds the gnome. Bond.
Yes.
Okay, just no bonds. Bond. I like bonds. With a Z. Bonds.
Did somebody say cookies are ready? Cookies are ready?
Get your hand off my cookie.
From scratch.
What are you doing?
These are daddy's treats. Remember?
I should have some. I really shouldn't eat all of them, but
He's gonna eat all 50.
So good. Babe, those are very good.
Are they?
So good.
Did I overcook them?
No, they're perfect. Anyways, during this whole coronavirus situation that we're all in, there's been some rough days, but there's also been really good days. And right now we're just trying to figure it out, finding that new rhythm, and just keeping our heads up, staying positive, being in prayer. Love you.
Yeah, boo-boo.